Alright, this is Christina with DC Anime Review, and we're going to be discussing Season 1, Episode 12, and joining me is Poja and Doreen.
I hate this show.
I do too.
I do not like To Your Eternity. It's messing with my emotions.
It's sad. It's very sad.
This episode got me.
It broke you. You broke.
It broke me.
Yeah, you broke.
I broke with March, but I broke really bad with this one.
Yeah, I know. Gugu's death was... poof, it was fucked up.
Mm-mm. I am not happy about that with Gugu, and he's still, like, the thing is, like, he risked his life for the girl he loved. And it's just so sad to me, because I was like, no, not him. Anything but him. And for the way he died was so fucked up.
I actually thought it was gonna be Rin that was gonna die, because when Gugu was fighting the knockers, he was saying when his powers got taken away, he's like, he wasn't feeling any pain. He was like, this isn't my pain. So I'm like, wait a minute, what if Rin's really the one dead and not Gugu? And I was like, no, don't kill her off. Well, I feel like she's next. Is she next?
I don't know.
I don't know, because you know what's crazy? Because when he said that about the pain with Fuji, I heard him say Gugu first before and then he's like, then he said after Gugu, then he's like, this is not my pain.
Yeah.
Which
that's what confused me. I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah. It was so confusing because because you think with Rin, like, she could easily get hurt. Like, seriously, like, for her to go, to risk her life to go back over there just to talk to Gugu, just to confess how she feels about him.
How she felt that she loved him. And then, of course, this episode decides they can't be happy together.
We can't have happy things. In this show. This is gonna be Berserk, isn't it? This is gonna be another Berserk, isn't it?
Definitely. Well, not as dark as Berserk. I don't think it's dark, but not like.
No, I don't know. Berserk was worse. I'm going off on a tangent. Whoever says Griffith did nothing wrong, get yourself checked.
Agreed.
Agree. Exactly. Agree. Because, oh my god, it's crazy because, like, the beginning, when we watch the beginning of the episode, okay, we know that the bridge collapsed, balcony. Like, between them, the balcony collapsed. And then there was, like, these worm-like things coming out through the rock.
We've seen enough anime to know that those are tentacles, like, come on.
I know that. I know.
That's bad news.
That's always bad news. And then those knockers, like, again, comes back, and they really came back because the Fuji was still there. And that's the reason they wanted to go after Fuji.
That's what they're aiming for. That's what they really want. Like, they just want him.
The beholder person is trying to hurt him because he's not listening.
Exactly. He's punishing him now because he said he wanted him to not stay there. He wanted him to move on, and he's not listening.
Exactly.
So now he needs to take... Now he's like, okay, fine, you're not listening. I'm going to take everything that you love away from you.
Yep.
Yeah. And you're gonna deal with the consequences for not listening to what I have to, like, telling you, you need to listen to me. But Fuji is like, I refuse because I'm happy here. I'm happy with my brother, Guru. I'm happy where I am. And there's nothing you could do about it. And then, of course, this hurt Fuji so bad. He gets to him this way by, like, warning him about the knocker. And the thing is that when he fights the knocker, of course, it's bad because he's losing confidence in himself because he's like, he doesn't know how to beat them.
He feels helpless and he can't do anything.
Exactly.
And these knockers keep taking away, you know, people he cares about. And, well, I mean, I don't know what this beholder person is planning, but it's like, they're going to have to find a way to, you know, to stop the knockers and the beholder one way or another. And I feel like more people are going to die.
I feel that. And I was, you know how funny, I was talking about my theory about this, that Fuji's going to deal with this. He's going to deal with life and death and about humanity.
Well, even what he said, why do I have to go through this?
Yeah.
Like, he has to deal with trying to hide the fact, like, he was trying to hide the fact that Gugu was dead.
Yeah.
And, like, everyone that's close to him, he feels like he has to take the barrier and take the fault of it and deal with it, kind of thing.
Yeah, the fact that he told Rin, like, towards the end of the episode, like, he told Rin that, you know, Fushi was the one who died, but she knew.
She knew already.
Yeah, she knew who really died.
Yeah, because I don't think she totally lost her memory there when she knew Gugu was protecting her.
I think it was the potatoes.
Yeah, it was definitely...
Or the buns, not the potatoes. Sorry, the buns.
He always loved those potatoes, like those bread.
The buns.
He was. That's how she knew.
I think
that's how she knew it wasn't Fuji. Yeah. Fuji doesn't like those things. She knows that Gugu always liked those buns because she was with them for 4 years. So you don't think she knows what Gugu's favorite food is?
Exactly. Yeah. Can we appreciate Gugu's brother?
I actually, to this episode.
We take back every single mean thing we said about you, Shin.
Yes. Exactly. For him to do what he did, like, to continue working his brother's job, doing his brother's chores.
Yes.
And actually, what's interesting, like, he actually, when he saw his brother, like, he actually carried his brother like he did when he was a little boy.
Yes.
And it's so sad, like, that he had to... It was a sad way, like, how he learned his lesson, but in a very hard way.
Yeah, he learned his lesson. Now he has no brother.
He had no brother, and that's what hurts, because he realized, I really made a big mistake. And when he was trying to, like, please forgive me, brother, he wouldn't even take it. Gugu was so angry at him. He's like, you know, like, I don't forgive you. And then I think at this moment, it was sort of a peace in a way, especially the spirit of Gugu feeling his presence, like carry him all the way. Like, so that was really interesting about that. And for Shin, I have to give him, like, he really did change his way and he really became responsible.
It was the cost of his younger brother's death, but you know. Yeah. He finally realized, you know, how to be responsible.
Exactly. And it's a sad way how he learned that. How to actually
grow up.
It was too late, yeah.
It was too late. And I was like, you know what? For this episode, this one, I actually will take back what I said about Shin, that he became a better man because of his younger brother, and now knowing that he's never gonna see his brother again, but he'll in spirit he's with him. But the thing is, like, I actually appreciate that Shin actually, like, decided to be responsible and continue Gugu's work, which is very interesting.
Yeah, that's very commendable. And also, you know, Rin's friends and her fiance, they were, like, all helping Gugu in the beginning.
And exactly.
They didn't care what he looked like now, and they were, like, helping him. So, yeah, you can't judge a person by how they look.
Exactly. And that was really nice about that. And
you have to judge a person by character, not by looks. That's how I see it.
Exactly. Children out there.
And, but you know, there was one thing that made me happy in the beginning of the episode was the brotherhood between Gugu and Fuji.
Yes!
I love that so much. That how he would, like, he worried about Fuji. Fuji would worry about Gugu.
Yes! Oh, now it's stripped away.
And it was so awesome. I was, like, so rooting for that. I was like, oh my god, this is awesome.
That's why Fuji took the death so hard.
Yeah, it hurt him. Yeah, it hurt him badly.
It hurt him bad.
So should we go final thoughts?
Final thoughts? I hate this episode. Gugu shouldn't have died. and they don't want him to be happy.
Those are your final thoughts.
Yes, and I don't trust that.
Beholder.
Was it his name?
Beholder.
Yes. I don't.
Well, I mean, he's pretty shady. He's wearing a cloak. He looks like fucking Voldemort, and he speaks like Xehanort from Kingdom Hearts. So.
Yeah, I don't trust the Beholder.
Jeremy, final thoughts?
My final thoughts. I'm gonna say I was not happy that we had to see another death in the series. Like first, March was hard, but I think Gugu was a lot harder because. Fuji, and I noticed that Fuji had more emotional
connection.
He was more traumatized. I mean, yes, Marsh was like the first that he actually felt that emotion, but I was like, definitely with Gugu, like you felt that emotion. He was like very.
Yeah, because he was with.
Because he just said that was his brother, and he lost.
Yeah, exactly. That was his brother. Yeah.
Exactly, and I don't.
I think we got more attached too because we had more of
episodes.
Backstory and everything.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, March, we only had like 5 episodes and a little bit. Gugu, we had, I don't even fucking know how many episodes we had. We had a lot of episodes with Gugu, and he had a lot of character development. Go ahead.
And speaking about March, which is interesting because I wonder if Fuji sees them, like the spirit of Gugu and March.
I think so. I think he does.
I have a feeling. And it seemed like Gugu looked back, and that's, he actually seeing the first time he see March. Like, and she was like hiding shyly behind him.
Yeah.
And she's a little scared of him. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of interesting and cute because you see that somehow, even though they're not with him physically, they're with him spiritually, which is so interesting.
I feel like that's going to be more of a burden on him because he's going to keep seeing all these people dying.
It's gonna be more. I already was thinking about this series that people he meet along this way.
They're all gonna die.
It's gonna be like yes, there's stuff gonna be around him.
They're all gonna die. That's what I feel. But who knows? We might be wrong. But my final thoughts is fuck this show. I hate it. It keeps messing with our emotions. Damn it. Like, Gugu didn't deserve to die. March didn't deserve to die. I swear to God, if Rean is next, I'm gonna table flip something.
I mean,
come on, enough. Stop playing with our emotions. I know it's the same person that did a silent voice, but come on.
Mm-hmm. I know, and that one was bad, that one,
exactly,
too.
Exactly, yeah, but sorry we're about a week and a half late. You know, life happens. Mm-hmm. And we'll hopefully have another podcast for you next week, but it's not guaranteed, but we'll keep you updated.